I do think the pandemic made people insane, though. I got in a parking altercation with someone during the pandemic. It was a curb with two spaces on it, and this person took 1.5 spaces. They didn't pull all the way up. Okay, so I parked right behind them, bumper to bumper, squeezed my little car in so I wasn't bleeding over into the red. And she was watching me park from the basement where I believe her family keeps her. And she escaped, and she called the police. She said, "I'd like to report an accident." Yes, thank you. That is the right response. What? Yes. This ended up taking like 90 minutes of my day, okay? The cops came. We had to exchange driver's licenses. She was 30. Her name was Amy Catherine. I'm like, "You two first names, bitch. You are wasting my time," right? And she started crying like crazy LA tears, right? And she goes, "This is my grandmother's car. My grandmother just died. She left it to me, and you scratched the bumper." And I'm like, all right, that's a lot to unpack. But what's standing out to me right now is that you're 30 and your grandma just died. Wow, my grandma died before I was born. Check your privilege, bitch. I would have loved to have a grandma for 30 years. That's a lot of little birthday checks. And your grandma left you a car? Wow, my grandma died of cancer. You know what she left me? The gene for cancer. I should be crying right now, not you, Amy Catherine. And the car she was so upset about was a 2008 Hyundai. I'm like, you weren't even your grandma's favorite granddaughter. Your grandma had a wedding ring that she left to your cool cousin, Cassidy Madison. And then she's like, who do I leave this 14-year-old car to? Oh yeah, that fucking snitch, Amy Catherine. That cop caller.